And so now for a pedal board, I got an RMC wah, which I find is a very, I don't know, it has lots of throw. It's got lots of low end and lots of highs. We'll just give a little example, but a little noisy from being on the road and traveling, but you know, you'll get it. And then a little more wailing. That's the wah. I feel like it's, I don't know, when I switch back to other wahs, I like that one. It's a little pricey. Like I said, it's from RMC, but he puts out different models, got different choices. This one's just a basic one. I feel like he hit the one sound that I like. I don't really switch my wah sounds. Next is Jim Dunlop Roto Vibe, which is, you know, always great for putting some pads and layering pads down on rhythm guitar tracks and, well, even lead, I use a Leslie too in the studio, but this is great for a little more psychedelic stuff, some Hendrix, but you know, I like that it's got a foot controller. It's I like, you know, so I don't want to bend down or anything like that. I just, some nights if a song is faster, it's got to be a different setting. I want to be able to do it quick with my foot, so I like it. I might switch to another one. There's some other great Roto Vibes out there, but a lot of them don't use a foot controller, so I'll stick with this for now, but that's good. My next one in line is a Super Overdrive, but it's actually a Tube Screamer, an original TS9 Tube Screamer, and I pretty much only use it for feedback. I'll give an example later when I do a montage of stuff. I right now just got a pickup booster from Seymour Duncan, Because I'm typically, I gotta have my amp work for me. And then as a song progresses and gets more intense, I start hitting pedals. I get a little more, but typically it's just the amp. This is a good gain pedal, and use that just to give a little extra oomph when we're getting to the last half of the tune. I just got it because on the road in when I was in Europe, my Zen drive broke down, and it's a wire that's tucked underneath, and I couldn't get to it. But this Alfonso Hermida Zen drive is what I really like. It's it can go pretty gainy. I can get some different stuff in there, get real gainy, or I just kind of almost match it with my amp, and it's just almost a booster. So I really like that Zen drive. We'll get it going, be back on the board working again. A good fast tuner is the Boss tuner, which on the fly, it's great. It works quick. This Maxon, a lot of people ask about. It's the auto filter, and it's a lot of fun. It's just got a real quack noise. And I originally had an early 80s Ibanez, and I think this is a copy of that circuit. It's very touch sensitive. You can make it just go bassy or trebly, and make it just whack out like almost like an auto wah. But we'll just give this a second, and I'll show. It's just like it can be almost. So that's pretty funky. But I think that's pretty much for the pedal board, and I've been using that. I like using some delays sometimes, and I had an Octavia. But I travel now. It's April 2012, and now I'm currently in Lucky Peterson's band. So I even take off the Roto vibe, and it's just a little easier to travel. It's, you know, airlines are lowering poundage and how much you're allowed to take. So sometimes I only travel with a couple pedals, and just hopefully the amp is going to work all right.